So good morning to all of you. Today we are going to start the analysis of pre-stress-concrete beam. Already we have seen what is meant by stress concept, what is meant by strength concept, and what is meant by load balancing concept. We have seen in detail how to calculate the stresses by using stress concept, strength concept, and load balancing concept. Okay. So today we are going to see one problem in which for the same problem how we are going to calculate the stresses for midsection of the beam by using stress concept and load balancing concept. Okay, so today we are going to see one problem. So you can see here a pre-stressed concrete beam 400 mm by 600 mm in section has a span of 6 meter. The beam is pre-stressed with tendon bent as shown in figure below. So here the tendon is bent. We have taken problem that profile of tendon is bent. And the external load on the beam consists of the concentrated load of 160 kN at the midspan. So here point load we have considered 160 kN. If the effective pre-stressing force is 1000 kN, calculate the extreme stresses for the midspan section by using stress, strength and load balancing concept. So we have to calculate the stresses at midsection of this beam by using the three concepts. Okay, this is cross section of beam, cross sectional dimension 400 by 600. So as usual, first step we are going to calculate the cross sectional area of the beam. So cross sectional area of the beam 400 into 600, so that value become 2.4 into 10 to 5 mm square. Okay, so next is the section modulus. Section modulus here BD square by 6, so we have to put the value of B and D. So that value become 2.4 into 10 to 7 mm cube. After getting the two values, that is area and section modulus, next now we are going to start to calculate the stresses. So first thing we are going to calculate the stresses by using stress concepts. So what we required in a stress concept is first is a dead load. Okay, so dead load on beam, so self weight of beam 0.4 into 0.6 into 25, this is density of concrete. So if you are going to multiply it with this, you are going to get the load UDL on the self weight load of the beam, that in the form of UDL, that is 6 kN per meter. Okay, and the external bending moment at center. Now we have to calculate the bending moment at center for stress concept. If you can see the diagram here, for stress concept we are going to calculate the bending moment diagram. Now bending moment diagram due to this point load will be the WL/4, and due to the self weight of beam, okay, due to the weight of beam, that value become WL²/8. Okay, so addition of these two we have to consider. So here you can see this WL/4, this is movement due to the point load, and this is WL²/8, this is due to the external load. Okay, so here external load 7, so total load here, that point load 160 kN, so 160 kN into 6 divided by 4, that plus 7, that is W, that is external load, this is external load, so 7 into 6 square, that is length square, length here you can see the length given is 6 meter. So after putting these values, you got the value here 271.5 kN per meter. Okay, and after knowing this value, the extreme stresses at midspan we have to calculate. For midspan, the direct stress P by A, this is due to pre-stressing force, direct stress, this is stress due to the eccentricity of the tendon. So eccentricity here, you can see the eccentricity here, this value is 150. So this E we have to consider. So when you are going to calculate the stresses at midsection of the beam, we have to consider the stresses due to the pre-stressing force, and stresses due to the pre-stressing force is P by A. Okay, stresses due to eccentricity here, that is P by E divided by Z, and stresses due to the bending moment, that value we are going to consider M by Z. So by considering that all values, here we can see the formula P by A minus plus P into E divided by Z plus minus M by Z. Why we have to consider this is minus here? Already we have discussed that if eccentricity is this, the force is going to try to bend beam like this. Okay, that movement is try to bend the movement that beam like this. So that beam is going to bend is like this. Okay, in the opposite direction. If you are going to see the opposite direction, here is a tension. Opposite direction of the bending profile due to the superimposed load or self weight of the beam. So here you can see the tension, here you can see the compression. So that's why we have taken minus P, that sign we have considered for tension, and plus sign we have considered for compression. So that minus sign we have considered for tension. So here you can write the tension minus and plus here compression. So moment due to the dead load that and superimposed load that M by Z, here is at top compression, bottom tension, because due to dead load beam is going to bend like this. So that's why here is a compression, here is a tension. So sign for compression we have used plus, for tension minus. So here you can say plus minus. After putting the values in this formula, we are going to get the various values. The stress due to the direct stress is 4.16, the stress due to the eccentricity, and stress due to the bending. Okay, bending stresses. So all values you have got, and now we are going, if you are going to consider the stresses, top stresses, stresses at top fiber and stresses at bottom fiber. If you are going to consider the values at top fiber minus and this plus at top, and the plus and minus at a bottom while calculating the stresses. After putting the values, we are going to get the stresses at top stresses 9.22 newton per mm square, and bottom stresses minus 0.9 newton per mm square. So these are the stresses by considering the stress concept. Okay, so hope that you have got this concept. Already we have solved one problem by using the stress concept earlier. Now we are going to see the second concept. So see here, the second concept is strength concept. Already we have discussed in strength concept, we have to find the distance between P line and C line. C line is a concrete line and P line is a force line. So first we have to calculate the shift of line, shift of line C from line P. So for that we have used formula M by P, that is total moment. Moment already we have calculated. So 271.5 × 10⁶ divided by pre-stressing force. So that value A is 271.5, and eccentricity of line C above the central axis now will be the 271.5 minus 150. So that value become 121.5. Okay, already we have discussed, if this is beam, okay, and if I am going to consider this line is P line, okay, and suppose if I am going to consider this line as a C line, the distance which we have calculated, this distance A is the distance between these two, and if I am going to consider the centered axis beam will be here somewhere. And which thing you want? We want the eccentricity E value, that is the distance from C line to the central axis. So what we have to do here, the total A minus 150, so what is position here, the P line. So P line here you can see here, the position of P line at center from the centroid is 150. So 150, so this 150 minus from A, this 150 we are going to subtract from the value of A, so we will get the value of eccentricity, and that eccentricity value here 121.5. okay, and by considering this value, we know formula for stress concept, that C by A, that C we are going to consider as a pre-stressing force, plus minus C into eccentricity divided by Z. After putting the value of eccentricity in this formula, again you are going to get the stresses, that stresses, direct stress and stresses due to the eccentricity of C line, that 5.06. so stresses at top fiber and bottom fiber again here 9.22 and minus 0.9. please remember the stresses values either in stress concept, in strength concept or load bearing concept will be the same at midsection. Okay, so this is about the strength concept. Already we have discussed, but once again I have taken the problem, one problem in that we are solving the we are calculating the stresses by using the all concept. Okay, hope that you understood this thing. And next year and last concept, that is load balancing concept. So for load balancing concept, already we know the tendon is bent tendon here, The tendon is bent tendon, and due to this bent tendon, here, this is going to exert the pressure on the tendon. Okay, this tendon is going to exert the pressure on the concrete, and that pressure value, already you know that that force, inclined force, that inclined force P sine theta is going to give to the concrete. And if you are going to take addition, the net force is 2P sine theta. So we have to calculate the net force here. Okay, load balancing concept means due to provision of this bent tendon, the inclined force is going to generate vertical force, that P sine theta, and that P sine theta is going to reduce the amount of load. Okay, and that concept is nothing but a load balancing concept. Okay, so we have to calculate now the net force here. So that let the tendon at the be at theta with the horizontal tan theta. So we have to calculate the value of theta. So theta here, 150 divided by 3000. How it is 150 by 3000? So you can see here, this is 150. If I am going to take this value, okay, this value, remaining value here, total 600. So this is 300. So this value is also 150. So front distance divided by adjacent side, so that distance will be 150 divided by 3000. That beam length is, total length is 6 meter. So here we have to consider 3 meter, in mm this is 3000. So that value become 1 by 20. The inclined tendon will provide an upward force at mid span. So upward force here 2p sine theta. Since that value of sine theta is very small, we are going to consider that theta as a tan theta. After putting the value, you are going to get the net upward force is 100 kN and downward force here 160, upward is 100. So total net force here 60 kN. And after getting the force, we are going to calculate the bending moment. Bending moment due to the force and due to the self weight of the beam. So that value here, so that external load, so 60 net we have to consider into L by 4 and 7 into 6 square by 8. So that value become 121.5. And after putting that value, extreme stresses at mid span, so here P by A plus minus M by Z. After putting the value, again we are going to get the values here. Direct stress is 4.16, and stress due to the eccentricity due to that tendon, okay, sorry, the stress due to that external load movement, that is 5.06. after putting that values at top fiber and bottom fiber plus and minus, that value become 9.22 and minus 0.9. so you can see here, by solving the problem with, this is load balancing concept, okay, by using strength concept, the values answer you can see here 9.22 and 0.9. here in load balancing concept also 9.22 and 0.9, and in strength concept also that value is 9.22 and minus 0.9. so stresses at top fiber and bottom fiber. So this how we are going to solve the problem, okay, when the beam is subjected with the point load and UDL. Then we can solve this problem by using three concepts, okay. So this is end of this problem. Next lecture we are going to see the parabolic tendon and how to calculate the stresses by considering the parabolic tendon with the eccentricity at the mid span. Okay, thank you.